एंड कम्युनिकेशन। इन दिस चैप्टर वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द लैंड ट्रांसपोर्ट इन विच वी कवर्ड रोडवेज एंड रेलवेज, राइट। नाउ इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस द सेकेंड मोड ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्ट, दैट इज वाटर ट्रांसपोर्ट, राइट। सो वाटर ट्रांसपोर्ट इज द ओल्डेस्ट मोड ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्ट। इन द एशियन टाइम्स oceans and rivers are used for the navigation. Oceans and rivers were used to travel, for the traveling of passengers as well as to carry the loads and freights, right? But by the technological advancement, the waterways is advancing more and more. Its great advantage is that it does not require route construction. It is the most great advantage of water transport, that it requires no route construction. So initially, it has a low cost, but it has a great maintenance cost after that, to maintain the ships, to maintain the harbors or all that, it costs high. But at the initial stage, it has a less cost. Port facilities are provided at the two ends, and it is much cheaper than that of land, because ships are used to carry heavy and bulky cargoes and to carry the load and unload the goods. The port facilities are provided on both of the sides of oceans as well as rivers. Water transport can be divided into two: ocean transport, ocean routes, and inland ways, right? So one by one we will focus on these two. First is oceanic routes. Ocean routes, that is, offers us, first of all, it offers us, the advantages of oceanic routes are, the first, it offers smooth highway with turnable in all the direction with low maintenance cost, right? So there is a low maintenance cost. Second, it is an important development by humans to go easily to any part of the world. By the oceans, we can go to any part of the world, because the continent is separated from the other with the oceans, and we go through with these oceans and travel to the another continents also. If it is compared to land and air, ocean transport is cheaper, right? As I told you that there is no need to lay down the tracks or the routes, so the cost is low, and moreover, it can carry heavy and bulky goods in huge quantity, so the cost is cheaper than the land and air transport. Bulky materials can be traveled to over long distances from one continent to another. If we have to transport the bulky materials, heavy materials, to another continent, we will use the oceanic routes. With the advancement of time and technology, modern passenger ships and cargo ships are equipped with radar, wireless, and other navigation apps. What would happen in the past, that in the past there was a storm in the oceans, but the navigators do not know how and when will the storm come. So there is in some of incident where the navigators lost their life, right? But now with the advancement of technology, these cargoes, these ships are equipped with radar. They can see in the heavy storms also, and by these radars they can forecasting the storms also, right? So there is a wireless facilities are also there, and other so many navigations ads are facilitate the ships and cargoes, and it make the journey safer than the previous one. The development of refrigerated chambers for perishable goods. Now, perishable goods or can also be transported to another continent, which can retain only for 1 or 2 days, right? But now these commodities like fruits, vegetables, all these can be transported to another continents by the ships because of the refrigeration facilities. What happened in the past in these fruits, vegetables, or other meat or other things cannot be provided to each and every country, right? Due to the lack of refrigeration facilities. By this facility, now you can use other companies' material things in your own country. Moreover, to transport the liquid material, tankers are prone there, and some specialized ships has also improved cargo transport, right? So specialized ships improved cargo transport means cargos are the they contain the containers of goods, right? Now come to the important oceanic routes. We have 6 important oceanic routes. First is the North Atlantic route, the Mediterranean and the Indian Ocean route, the third, the Cape of Good Hope route, the fourth, the South Atlantic route, the fifth, the North Pacific route, and the sixth one is the South Pacific route. And the two more routes are there which are man-made, that is the Suez Canal and the Panama Canal, which is the greatest achievements of man in the field of transportation. Now we will focus all these 8 routes one by one. The first is North Atlantic Sea Route. Before discussing this route, you must know what is the reason of North Atlantic, right? So focus on this map. So in this map, here you can see the Atlantic Ocean. This is North America, South America, it is Europe, and this is Africa. And between these 4, there is a Atlantic Ocean. Now we are talking about the North Atlantic Ocean. So this, suppose this is equator. So above the equator, this part of ocean is known as North Atlantic Ocean, right? Now in this picture you can see which countries can be joined by this route. Here in the North Atlantic Ocean, western side is North America and eastern side is Europe, correct? And South America and Africa can also be connected by this route. Okay, now have a look. North Atlantic Sea Route is the most important and busiest oceanic route of the world. Why? Because it connects 2 major continents of the world, North America and Europe. Right, so these are 2 advanced continents, and that's why this is the busiest sea route in the world. Correct, both coasts have good port and harbors facilities. Right, about 1/4 of the world's cargoes is transported along this route, means 25% of the world's cargo transported by this route. Some major ports on both sides are New York. In this map, you can see some of the major ports. First is New York, right? Montreal, Quebec, Halifax, Boston, St. John, Portland, Baltimore, all these situated on this side, right? And in the eastern side, the most important port is London, right? London, Liverpool, Glasgow, Manchester, Southampton, Rotterdam, Hamburg, Stockholm, Oslo, all these are the important ports established on the eastern coast of Atlantic Ocean. Correct? So, what type of items are exported and imported by these routes? As you know, Europe is an advanced country. It is famous for its finished goods, right? So, Europe exports large quantities of manufactured items like textiles, chemicals, machineries, fertilizers, steel, and wine to the United States and Canada, means North America, and North America. In return, what did North America supply? It supplied bulky and large quantities of food grains, raw materials, white, wheat, wood pulp, copper, as well as iron and steel, transport equipment, etc. are sent to the Western Europe through this route. Now you have to remember one thing always. Europe is an advanced country and it is famous for finished foods. So whenever Europe will trade with another country, it will transport the finished goods, while the other countries like North America, Asian countries, they will export the food items. Clear? So remember always. Now come to the next route, that is the Mediterranean Indian Ocean Sea Route. Mediterranean Indian Ocean Sea Route. First of all, what is this route? In this picture, you can see here is a Suez Canal, right? So over this Suez Canal, you can see the white portion, right? So this is Mediterranean. Clear? So this is Mediterranean Sea and here is Asia, right? So, Mediterranean and the Indian Oceanic route. This is our Indian Ocean. So, if the Asian countries have to trade with the European countries, they have to go through with this route from South Africa to the Mediterranean Sea. By this route, they can reach to the European countries. So this route connects the developed countries of Europe in the west with the developing countries of East Africa, South Asia, and Southeast Asia through the Mediterranean Sea, the Red Sea, and the Indian Ocean. Almost the entire ocean-bound traffic from Europe to East Africa, Asia, and Australia passes through this route. Right, it provides a major trade link between the East and the Western countries, Asian and the European countries. So, eastbound cargo mainly consists machinery and industrial products, and westbound cargo includes mineral oil and agriculture products. Means eastbound cargoes, which comes from the European countries, they contain machinery and industrial products, while with the cargoes went to the western side, European countries, they contain mineral oil and agriculture products like cotton, rubber, tea, coffee, and sugar. The major port are Port Said, Aden, Mumbai, Kochi, Colombo, Singapore, all these are the major seaport. In this map, you can see Mumbai, Karachi, Colombo, right? So these are the major seaport, right? Now, as I told you that the ships have to travel through Asian countries from the Indian Ocean to the, and they have to travel throughout Africa, and crossing the South Atlantic Ocean, they reach to the Mediterranean Sea. So it is the longest sea route. So that's why The Asian countries restrict their trade with the European countries because they take a lot of time and lot of cost. So they avoid the trade with the European countries. Now, what happened? The man with their advancement, they find out a midway of this route that is called Suez Canal. Right. So they opened an area from Mediterranean Sea that connects directly Indian Ocean. Right. So that is Suez Canal route. Suez Canal route is one of the greatest achievement of man in the field of transportation and navigation. It connects Mediterranean Sea and Red Sea. The construction work of this canal was started in 1854 by a French engineer, Frederick de Lesseps, and was completed in 1869. It was a great achievement. What were the advantages of Suez Canal? First of all, the construction of this canal has opened a shorter route between European countries on one hand and the countries of East Africa and Asia on the other hand. This has drastically reduced the distance between various countries. If the cargoes have to travel following the Cape of Good Hope route and move around Africa, as a result of this canal, the distance as compared to the Cape of Good Hope route has reduced 9,600 kilometers between London and Mumbai. If a cargo is moving from London to Mumbai through the Cape of Good Hope, it has the longest route, but by the Suez Canal, it is shortened the distance of 9,600 kilometers. So it reduced the distance as well as the time. European countries, especially Britain, got the most benefits from this canal and is known as the jugular vein of the British Empire, right? Because due to this canal, the Britishers can travel to the Asian countries and can trade. So this is the most important for the Britishers. Now come to the third one, the Cape of Good Hope Sea Route. The Cape of Good Hope Sea Route, in the map you can see Australian and Indian or Asian countries, they follow the Cape of Good Hope route. Here is a Cape Town, right? So this is a Cape Town and the ships have to travel through Indian Ocean, then South Atlantic, and then they reach to the European countries. This is the Cape of Good Hope Sea Route. This trade route connects the highly industrialized Western European region with the West Africa and South Africa, Southeast Asia, and the commercial agriculture and livestock economies of Australia and New Zealand. The volume of trade and traffic between both east and west of the Africa is on the increase due to the development of rich natural resources. Why there is a development of this route? Because in the west and east Africa, there is a gold mine, diamond, copper, tin, groundnut. All these resources are found. And to transport these goods to the European and Asian countries, this route was developed, right? So to exploit the rich resources of African nations, this route was constructed. Okay, the next route is South Atlantic route. South Atlantic route, come to this map again. South Atlantic route, as I told you, below the equator, this portion is known as South Atlantic portion. And South Atlantic is connecting the South America and the Western South Africa, right? So South Atlantic route provides link between the Western Europe, Western African countries, and port of Brazil. See again, it connects Western Europe, Brazil, Western South Africa, and South African countries, right? So it is less developed as compared to North Atlantic route. Why? There are some reasons. Because first of all, South America and Africa, which are connected by these routes, they are less developed continents and having sparse population. They have limited economic development. So the trade between the South America and the South Africa is very little. So the trade between Rio de Janeiro and Cape Town is also not much developed, because both Africa and South America have similar product and resources. They have also same products, and these region have also same products. So the trade cannot be done by done between these two countries, right? Only coffee and cocoa from Brazil and wheat, meat, wool, and flax from Argentina. Here is Brazil. Here you can see the Brazil. This is Brazil. So Brazil is a leading producing country of coffee and cocoa, and wheat, meat, wool, and flax from Argentina. Here is Argentina. This part sent these industrial countries of North America and Western Europe. They provide their products to the North America and the Western Europe. The next route is the North Pacific route. North Pacific route, here is same. North Pacific considered as the part of, above the part of equator, right? So between the Asian and the American countries, there is a Pacific Ocean. So it will connect the these two, right? So there is, here in this picture, you can see the this port Honolulu, right? So it is a convergence point, because Pacific Ocean is the largest ocean, and by crossing the this ocean, the ships have to stay wherever, and the meeting point is Honolulu, right? So it links Vancouver to Yokohama, Shanghai, Hong Kong, Singapore. All these countries are connected with this North Pacific route. The products which are transported by these routes are mainly American side deal with wheat, timber, pulp, palm, fish, and dairy products. And while the North American consists textile, electrical equipment from Japan, Hong Kong, South Korea, Taiwan, all these materials can be transported by these countries, Japan, Hong Kong, South Korea, Taiwan, and tropical raw materials from Southeast Asia, like rubber, copra, palm, oak, tea, all these materials are transported to the North American countries by this route. Clear? Now the next is the South Pacific route. Below the equator in the Pacific Ocean, there is a South Pacific route, and the traffic on these routes consists mainly of ships traveling via the Panama Canal. Here in this picture, you can see this is a Panama Canal, right? So Panama Canal between either Western Europe or North America and Australia. If Australia, North America, Western Europe, if they have to travel, they have to use this Panama Canal. right? So before construction of Panama Canal, the Australian ships have to use this route. They have to cross the South America and then Atlantic Ocean, and then they reach to the European countries, or either they have to use the route of Cape of Good Hope, right? So it they have to cover a long distance, so they their trade is not so much advanced. But by the construction of Panama Canal, the trade between Australia, America, and Europe has been increased. So this route is also used for reaching Hong Kong, Philippines, Indonesia, which are our Asian countries here, right? So goods transported are mostly wheat, meat, wool, fruits, dairy products. All these items are transported to the American countries and to the European countries by this route, right? Now, the Panama Canal. Panama Canal is also a man-constructed canal which shortened the route and make the trade possible between Asian countries, here Asian countries, and European countries, and with North America and South America, right? So this canal was constructed and it lined between the continents of North America and South America. It was lying between the North America and the South America. It connects the two great oceans, here the Pacific Ocean and here the Atlantic Ocean, which is connected by this canal, right? So it provides the route to reach the European countries in less time. It was constructed and owned and controlled by the United States and constructed in 1906 and completed in 1914. What is the importance of Panama Canal? Before the completion of this canal, ships had to undertake long and hazardous voyage around the stormy Cape Horn. These routes, they have to use, but it has helped in increasing the trade between the countries of Atlantic and Pacific Oceans. Now the Atlantic and Pacific Oceans countries can trade by this canal. So here we have completed all the oceanic routes. If you have any doubt regarding these routes, you can ask. The next mode of transport we will discuss in